This morning I had a short dream that I want to share with you. In this dream we were like in a classroom and I saw the teacher writing the subject of the class. And when it was written and I saw it, I was really excited and happy about it. But nobody else seemed to be happy about it. And the teacher wrote change of doctrine from Catholicism to saints. And when I saw it, actually, I was so excited that I said, Amen, may we be saints. And later, as we were expanding the subject and speaking about it, I thought it was important about speaking how the scriptures is not the word of God, because many Christians believe wrongly that the scriptures is the word of God, and this is a deception. Because many Christians will be denied entrance into the kingdom of God, not because they didn't know the scriptures, but because they didn't know the true word of God, which is Jesus Christ himself, as the scriptures itself says. In this dream, my brother who was near me, he was showing me from the Old Testament that the Old Testament mentions the Word of God, and he was showing me examples about where these mentions of the Word of God are. And I told him, yes, of course, the Word of God is mentioned there, but it never says the scriptures is the word of God. And I showed him in my dream an example from 1 Kings chapter 13 to what the real word of God is. And I'm going to show you the example that I showed him in the dream. It's from 1 Kings chapter 13. I start showing you exactly what I showed in the dream, and then after that I will explain a little bit so that you get a better picture of what the example truly is. I start reading from verse 20. Now it happened as they sat at the table that the word of the Lord came to the prophet who had brought him back. And he cried out to the man of God who came from Judah, saying, Thus says the Lord. Now, this is the word of God, dear friends. Because you have disobeyed the word of the Lord and have not kept the commandment which the Lord your God commanded you, but you have came back and ate and drank water in the place of which the Lord said to you, Eat not bread and drink not water. Your corpse shall not come to the tomb of your fathers. Now, I want to show you a little bit about what the story is. So the chapter, I start from chapter 13. And behold, a man of God went from Judah to Bethel by the word of the Lord. So this man could have never written the scriptures and known that he has to go from Judah to Bethel. No, it was God who spoke to him. This is the word of God. This is the true word of God. And further down, this man of God says at verse 9, For so it was commanded me by the word of the Lord, saying, You shall not eat bread nor drink water, nor return by the same way you came. So he went another way and did not return by the same way he came to Bethel. Now, dear friends, this is the true word of God. And I want to tell you that the Bible never mentions the scriptures being the word of God, because the Bible itself was written by people who knew the true word of God, and they know he's alive and active, as written in Hebrews chapter 4. They knew the word of God. They couldn't have mentioned and said the scriptures is the word of God, because the word of God is not a book. And in John chapter 1, it's written, the word of God was God, and he came in the flesh here on earth, and he gave his life for us, dear friends. This is the true word of God. And unfortunately, many Christians will not inherit the kingdom of God because they didn't know the word of God. Unfortunately, many Christians are so deceived, they don't even believe Jesus. They don't believe his words. Jesus Christ is the word of God. We have to obey him. Most Christians are so deceived, they think they follow Jesus, but they don't. It's because they thought they knew him. Why, Jesus will declare to many Christians, I never knew you. Depart from me. Neither of us want to wait until that day to find out we were deceived, believing something untruthful to be true, and finding out in that day that our truth, or the truth of people we looked up to and believed and trusted them with our salvation, to be actually false. Remember how the devil tried to deceive Jesus through one of his most trusted disciples. Now imagine how deceived must have been Peter. He was doing something good and scriptural in his eyes. But was he in the will of God? Don't put your trust in people for your own relationship with God. Don't even trust yourself or your own interpretation of the scriptures for your salvation. Pray and ask the Lord for his plan and purpose for your life. Don't wait until that day. Pray now and say, Lord, what is something that I believe to be true but is not? Because I want to deal with it now. I don't want to hear from him or her or anybody. Please seek my heart, Lord, and please reveal to me the truth. I only want to receive the truth from thee, Lord, because thee are the truth, Jesus. Please forgive my sins, Lord, and please teach and guide me by thy Holy Spirit as I deny myself and wait on thee, Lord, and keep my robes clean before thee, Lord Jesus. Pray and seek the Lord with all your heart, and you will find him. Then you will start your relationship with Jesus, and he will know you if you follow him and love him and obey him.